Today on Upfront, could Wisconsin have a sales tax holiday? Next, the plan to suspend the state's sales tax 2 weekends a year. Is this an idea gaining traction? Then his son died at the hands of Kenosha police. Today, a father's crusade to change the way officer-involved deaths are investigated. And new mortgage rules go into effect this week. Could it be harder for some customers to get a loan?
Covering the issues important to Wisconsin. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello and welcome to Upfront. I'm Kent Wainscott, filling in this week for Mike Gouchet. We hope you've had a good holiday season, and if some state lawmakers get their way, you might see a different kind of holiday in Wisconsin, a sales tax holiday. Two Republican lawmakers are pushing for a break from sales tax for 2 weekends a year, one in August for back-to-school shopping, and one in November for energy-efficient appliances. Assembly Speaker Robin Voss gave this idea a boost in a recent interview, and today we're talking with the Senate author of the sales tax holiday, Republican Rick Gudex of Fond du Lac. Welcome to Upfront. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Talk to me about the reason this came about. Why are you pushing a 2-weekend-a-year sales tax holiday?
Well, the impetus behind this stems from the fact that we are seeing excess sales revenue. And when we start to see that kind of revenue come in, we start to think about ways we can help people in the state of Wisconsin. And this idea isn't new. There's 18 other states that do this, and Puerto Rico as well. And the idea is that we would have a sales tax holiday the first weekend in August, and that would relate to school supplies, anything to do with school supplies. It would be a tax-free weekend where there would be no tax on items of clothing, shoes, apparel, computers, any kind of school supplies needed for school or college. Those are the types of things we're looking for. And then we thought we'd take it a step further and go to November, the first weekend in November, and have an Energy Star weekend where you'd have a weekend that would be tax-free, buying things like old appliance. You get rid of old appliances. You buy new washers, dryers, freezers, you know, things like that, and also including windows, caulking, and the like. So I think this is a good way that we can help the people of Wisconsin of all classes. Something that would resonate really well and keep money into the pockets of people that need to have it in their pocket.
Benefits the consumer. Does it benefit the merchant at all? Do you anticipate any increase in spending, or is this a situation where consumers just wait to make their purchases on those weekends and spend the money they're going to spend anyway?
Well, the merchants, of course, like this idea. You know, typically the first weekend in November is a slow weekend for merchants, so they're looking for something that would boost their sales. And you know, when it comes to how we deal with having people say that, well, we're just gonna shift our sales or shift our buying habits. You know, it doesn't really matter at this point where you buy. You know, any kind of deal that we can make here in the state of Wisconsin to help people keep money in their pocket is going to be a good thing. There are people on one side that say this is just a gimmick. You know, people are just going to change their habits, and it, you know, if putting money back into the pockets of people who need it is a gimmick, you know, then call this a gimmick. But this is something that we truly wanted to do to help all classes of citizens here in the state of Wisconsin.
You're optimistic this will pass.
I'm optimistic this will pass. I think that there's been some good press on this in the last couple of weeks. This is something that Representative Weininger and I brought forward back last February. So this has gotten a lot of talk, and right now it looks like this might become something that we want to pass before the end of the session.
So what sort of opposition do you anticipate?
Well, you know, I don't know what kind of opposition you may run into. I think the Counties Association would probably oppose this simply because there are half-cent sales taxes throughout the counties, some counties. So, you know, they may be hesitant to want to have this happen, but we're only talking 1 weekend, and we're talking about, you know, for the good of the people. But I don't see any other opposition to this at all.
The focus on sales tax relief is a little different than what we've seen discussed here in Wisconsin recently. Governor Walker has floated the idea, has talked about looking at the possibility of another property tax cut, of reducing or maybe even eliminating the state income tax. And one of the things that might be used to offset those tax breaks might be an increase in sales tax. At least that's what some are considering. So on one hand, you've got lawmakers who say, well, maybe the sales tax should be increased. You're looking at a reduction, at least partial reduction for a couple of weekends in the sales tax. How do you balance those two things?
Well, I think that, you know, and obviously if there's a movement to try and reduce taxes in the state of Wisconsin, that's something I'm certainly going to support. You know, if it calls for an increase in sales taxes to offset other taxes, that needs to be looked at by the full legislature and be vetted through the process. But I think what I'm trying to do is actually something that kind of is off track with what's going on in that mainstream tax discussion. I think that what I'm trying to do is just have 2 weekends a year where we can have a tax-free weekend for school supplies and Energy Star appliances that particularly help everybody, not certain classes, but every class of citizen in the state of Wisconsin. So I think it's a different conversation.
The notion that opponents say it's a gimmick might stem from the fact that it is just 2 weekends a year. What about the possibility of extending it? What does the future hold if you do, in fact, get this passed?
Well, you know, that's a great question because, you know, there are states who have actually seen a revenue increase despite having a sales tax holiday in the spending habits of the people. The state of Florida is a great example. They've actually seen an increase in sales tax while having a tax-free holiday. So, you know, people who are inclined to go out and buy items on that particular weekend may be inclined to buy other things that are taxable that weekend that maybe they hadn't thought about buying. And that's what we're hoping to have. And if that happens, and if the fiscal works out to be what I anticipate it to be, I would hope that we could expand this to other things throughout the state of Wisconsin. That'd be a great thing to do.
And so where do we go from here? You talk about being optimistic of getting this thing passed sometime in the next few months. Are we going through committee? Where do we stand with this?
Well, I would hope that we can get a committee scheduled, hearing scheduled in January. Obviously, the time frame is short here. You know, we're coming up to the spring session, and usually that session ends around the end of March or early April. We're hoping that we can get that part of maybe a package that would help streamline this as well. But I'm certainly optimistic that this will happen. I think that this is a wildly popular in the public sector.
And if it does, you hope to see this enacted in time for people to start
yeah.
getting this relief
there, by there's when? Actually, there's actually a little bit of a time crunch because merchants need to get things lined up for the August time frame. So we would need to have this in place this session to be able to have it in place for formally by June so that they have time, the retailers have time to set up their systems.
And quickly, the negative impact in terms of revenue generated would be what? Have you looked at how much the state might lose?
Yeah, the Fiscal Bureau estimated $14 million for the 2 weekends. I think that that's a bit heavy. I think that once you get people into the stores, they're going to utilize the tax-free options, but they're also going to be purchasing things that are taxable that they may not have wanted to purchase. So I'm hoping for a small fiscal on this. But regardless, you know, this is money that, you know, we want to try and keep in the pockets of people who need the money. And
we'll see how it plays out.
I'm optimistic.
Senator Rick Gudex, thanks very much
for taking some
time to be with us today. I appreciate it. Next, a father's crusade to change state law. A man whose son was shot and killed by police takes his case to state lawmakers and the court of public opinion. When Up Front continues.
Up Front with Mike Gouche, brought to you by American Transmission Company.